At the moment I started flying radio control airplanes, I also started getting interested in electronics. It's very interesting to be able to control a plane from the distance. It is something magical for me. With the introduction of racing drones, this interest intensified even more. When I started to build my own drones, I realized that I needed to have a minimum knowledge to make the connections correctly. At the same time, it was a great opportunity to start learning a little better about electronics in general. Components, what they are for, circuits, basic rules. And then, in that moment, I discovered Arduino. That's when I got into the programming of microcontrollers. And then everything changed. For now, I keep learning and probably never finish learning about this. To start working with Arduino, all you need to do is buy an Arduino or equivalent board and download the Arduino IDE in your computer. Today, I'm going to help you get started with Arduino by giving you some recommendations, some tips, and explain to you some things that you might find confusing at first. I apply my knowledge of Arduino, especially in my RC airplanes and drones, including a lighting system for an RC boat. You can see that video in the link that you see on the screen. But I've also used it for different projects that don't have to do with airplanes or anything that is radio control. But these challenges are fun, and during the process, I learn new things. Arduino is an open source platform, which means that the hardware and software are free to replicate and distribute. That's why you can find Arduino clones at a very low cost, and the Arduino IDE is free. Thanks to the popularity of Arduino, you can find a lot of information and support in forums and tutorials. Arduino is designed for people who know nothing about electronics and programming, and it is considerably easier to learn than other complex programming environments. Arduino is not the only one in the community. There are other similar brands that are compatible with the Arduino, but they all have a programmable microcontroller. There are also pre-assembled modules that work as input or output peripherals that can be sensors, lights, among others. These sensors can be used for a variety of tasks. These sometimes come in the form of the so-called shields, which makes it even easier to carry out a project, such as making a mobile phone or an MP3 player with your Arduino. In summary, Arduino and development boards in general facilitate the use of a microprocessor, which is basically a mini computer that will run a program that we do for our project, either something simple or more complicated. Arduino, as such, is the company that has developed this project and is located in Italy and continues to develop and sell its products that are of a wide variety, the Arduino Uno being the most popular board. In the market, we will find many boards that are the same but with different names, since the name Arduino can only be used by the company in its original products. Now let's start with the tips and recommendations to get started on this. Start learning everything you can about electronic components. What are they for and how to use them? The best way to learn is doing. So I recommend buying an Arduino kit that includes the basic components to make circuits of all kinds. Generally, this includes some LEDs, capacitors, resistors, transistors, cables, a breadboard, integrated circuits, buttons, and things like that. You must accompany this with theory, so you familiarize with the symbols of the schematics, so when you want to do your own circuits, you'll know how to read the schematic. And speaking about making your own circuits, this is something you can do with JLC PCB. With JLC PCB, you can order up to 10 PCBs for only $2, which is insane. If it's your first time ordering with JLC PCB, you will have a $20 discount on shipping if your order is more than $7. So definitely check them out, I'll leave a link in the description. Now back to the tips. Start learning to write code and its syntax. To program, you must follow some strict rules so that the code works. Writing the code correctly is critical. If, for example, you forget to put a semicolon after a closing brackets or misspell a line, there will be an error when compiling or using the code. So it's very important to start learning these simple rules and start studying the different functions. This brings us to a question. What programming language is used in Arduino? The answer is the C and C++ language. This is the language that is used in the essence of Arduino, but actually when writing your code is easier because they use predetermined libraries to make life easier. so we don't have to write a large and confusing amount of code, but we only write just some lines to achieve the same. However, you could use C and C++ code directly into the IDE without any problems. Let's talk a little bit more about libraries. A library can be composed of several files written in C or C++ that give more functionality to your Arduino projects. Libraries are those that allow you to write a very simple code without having much programming knowledge in the C or C++ language, since everything is written in advance. The only bad thing is that the libraries increase the size of the final program and occupy more memory on the microchip. But for now, you shouldn't worry about this, since most of the time you won't have any problem with this. There are libraries of all kinds, and many are developed by people or groups that like to collaborate with the Arduino community. To add a library, you must download it first, and then add it from the menu. If we see one of the examples, we see how it is included in the code with this declaration. Some libraries are already included in the Arduino IDE, called standard libraries. Other libraries must be installed by you depending on your needs. Some libraries are not compatible with all the Arduino boards, and some are compatible only with specific Arduino models or microcontrollers. And the last recommendation I can give you is to have a lot of patience and practice a lot, so that you learn by doing. Many times you will find many problems, but this is totally normal. So do not give up, because there is always a solution. You just need to have the knowledge. To start programming, I recommend studying the basic examples that are included in the Arduino IDE. You can copy the code of these examples and combine them with others to build your own projects. Let's take a look at how to program the use of a potentiometer to control the brightness of an LED digitally. First, let's open the Arduino IDE. If it's the first time you open this, this file will show up. This is the bare minimum code necessary to start programming. But let's open an example that have all the necessary code to achieve what we need. We'll go to File, Examples, and in the Analog section, or number 3, choose Analog In-Out Serial. This sketch opens up, which is the program we are referring to. At the top we have a comment that describes the code and even described what's needed for the circuit to be completed. A little bit lower we have a link to the Arduino website where you will find more information and a tutorial. Now let's start with the actual code. The first thing we notice are the constants. These are the pins that we're going to define as outputs and inputs. The input pin has to be analog. We can choose another one and we can change it here. The output pin has to be compatible with PWM signals. Then we have the variables. These are called variables because the value changes over time. We give them a name and their initial value, in this case 0, because this value will change according to the value of the potentiometer and the value of the LED light. Now let's go with the void setup. The code inside void setup runs only once after you turn on your Arduino. Right now we have the serial begin command, which is used to communicate with the computer. So the Arduino will send data to the computer and we can display the value collected from the potentiometer in real time. And finally we have the void loop. This is the main code of any program and it runs indefinitely. That's why it's called loop. You may have noticed that at the beginning of each line of code, there is a comment describing what's the line below about. These comments do not have any effect on the code, they're just a guide. In this part of the code, we will see the variables and their functions that makes the code work. In this case, we see that the variable sensor value will be equal to the value of the reading of the potentiometer. In output value, we will make a conversion of the value from the potentiometer, since that value can vary from 0 to 1023. But to light up our LED or control it, we can only use a value from 0 to 255. And that's why we use the function called map. And then we use the function analogWrite to write the value to an output pin. In this case, we use the pin where our LED is connected, and we use the value of our potentiometer that was converted before. And this way the LED will brighten in the correct amount according to the potentiometer position. The next part of the code is to print the data in the serial monitor. This is not necessary to make the code work. It is just to see the real-time data in your computer. So you could even delete it. And after that, we have a delay of 2 milliseconds. And there the code ends. And then it goes back to the first line of void loop and repeat the process. This process happens thousands of times per second, and that's why it will look fluid. Let's make the circuit real quick, and then upload the program to the Arduino to test it. In future videos we can make more circuits like this, but for now, this circuit is really easy to do. Before uploading the sketch to the Arduino, make sure that the right COM port is selected. Then we hit upload and we wait until the sketch is totally uploaded. This takes a few seconds. Your Arduino IDE will indicate when the code is totally uploaded. When it's done, you can now open the serial monitor if you want to see the real-time data while you move the potentiometer. And now we can see the results. As you can see, it was very easy. If you like radio controller airplanes, drones, and projects like this one, then consider subscribing. For now, I hope you liked this video, and I'll see you in the next project.